Hey, this is Kent. First of all, thank you so much for taking time out of your busy life to listen to the music. My prayer is that it has been an encouragement to you and will continue to be for years to come. This project took a full year to complete. My heart, along with the hearts of many others, is woven throughout the notes, melodies, and lyrics of this CD. But what's most important is that you can hear a little bit of the heart of God. I've never believed that I was called to entertain, but to encourage those who know Christ and introduce Him to those who don't. The best way I know to encourage those who know Christ is through the use of Scripture. And as for introducing Him to those who don't, it's always through the cross. The message of the cross is a message of redemption and hope. The first part of that is redemption from sin. You see, sometimes we hear that God wants to save us, but we're not told what He wants to save us from. Some wonder why they need saving. They're perfectly fine with life just the way it is. The Bible tells us, though, in the book of Romans chapter 3, verse 23, that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. There are those that would say they don't sin and that they're good people. But all it takes is a short trip to the Ten Commandments, God's law, to see that this just can't be so. Have you ever lied or stolen or been jealous of somebody else because of what they have? If you can say yes to any of those, then you have sinned, just like me. The Bible also tells us in Romans chapter 3, verse 10, that no one is righteous or innocent. No, not one. So how could we possibly think of ourselves as good? We're all in need of being saved. We have all at one time been lying, thieving, or jealous. And that's a reflection of us breaking only three of the Ten Commandments. So what is it that we need to be saved from? Because of our sin, we deserve punishment. The Bible teaches us that eternal separation from God is that punishment, and that's an eternity in hell. Jesus spoke of hell numerous times during His ministry here on earth. I realize that it's not the most pleasant subject matter, but obviously vital according to the words of Jesus. The awesome news is that God has provided a way for all to come to Him and avoid this eternal punishment. It's through the death of Jesus on the cross. You see, He took all of our sins upon Him and died for us, so that we might have the opportunity to experience eternal life in heaven. To experience this great gift, we must repent or turn from our sins. Ask God to forgive us of all of our past sin and accept what Jesus did on the cross to save our souls. Jesus said in John 14:6 that I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. You know, the world likes to say that there are many ways to gain eternal life in heaven, but as evidenced in the passage I just quoted, there is only one. My words and thoughts cannot save you and bring you into a relationship with Jesus Christ. That is between you and God. I can only encourage you to seek the truth of Scripture. I'd like to give you a few to begin with. These first few scriptures talk about the problem that we face. They can be found in Romans chapter 3, verse 10, chapter 3, verse 23, and the second half of chapter 6, verse 23. Now these next few give the solution to the problem. They can also be found in Romans chapter 5, verse 8, the second half of chapter 6, verse 23, chapter 10, verses 9 and 10, chapter 10, verse 13. Once you understand your need of a Savior, ask God to show you your sin and cry out to Him for forgiveness. Tell Him you are trusting in the death and resurrection of Jesus as the only way to an eternity with Him. Ask Him to save you, for Him to help you know that you've been saved. And then start living for Him. Life is not going to become perfect, but it'll become clear that no matter what you walk through, good or bad, that you are truly loved by the One who gave you life. For more scripture references, you can go to my website at www.kentbottenfield.com. If you don't have a Bible, I'd love to send one to you at no cost. You can also find other information to help you with your new life in Christ. Once again, thanks so much for listening, and God bless.